the make money online videos. I gave him a shot, right? I tested him out 2 months back. I tested Kevin David's tips to make money online with PayPal, all these things. I had some not so great results. Well, 2 months went by and I consistently tested his tutorials and a lot of these other guys' tutorials and had some very, very different results. So I'm gonna get right into how much I was able to make and the actual sites that made me the most, but just know that this video will help you, you know, save you from wasting time on stuff that just doesn't work.
Hey.
Now stick around because I tested out a lot of these websites and apps that pay out via PayPal, so if you skip around, there's a chance you won't hear something that, you know, you might have been looking for, or a website you may have heard of. There's a chance I tested it, so stick around. So if you haven't watched the previous two parts where I tested the tips for a week straight, Kevin David's tips, head back. There's two links in the description to part one and part two of that. But in them, I struggled to have any kind of real results. Because of that, I started to think it was just me. I didn't think, you know, I wondered anyway if it was just me, right? I knew that from my experience, this stuff wasn't working, but I also knew that, you know, a lot of people talk about these tips. So, you know, maybe there's a chance that I just didn't have a large enough data set, right? I didn't do it enough. So I did what any true scientist would do, and I recruited help. I asked my wife and one other friend to, as often as they could, but really just randomly, sporadically, test out these websites in their spare time. Quick interruption, 7 guys have come forward saying that they have replaced their entire income with affiliate marketing earnings using the free tutorials on this YouTube channel, so consider subscribing to follow in their footsteps. All of those minus, I tested out Fiverr and I didn't have them test Fiverr. So the three main websites, they tested random ones here and there, but the three main ones that were tested were TryMyUI, Userlytics, User Testing, and then a variety of transcribing audio websites. So the results that you're seeing on the screen right now are mine, so we're starting out with my results. They are honestly similar to what we've seen already if you watch part one and two. My wife, though, had different results, and my friend Jake also had some pretty different results, a lot better than mine. So I spent a few short stretches of like 10 to 45 minutes here and there, totaling, I would say, about 6 hours each month testing these things, right? And here were my results. So Userlytics, I earned a whopping 35 cents. User Testing, I made $10. TryMyUI was $12. Now there's a reason why I told you the time I spent, because I want to average this out to an hourly rate, right? A lot of these videos say make $200 per hour over and over again. Well, I wanted to put that specific claim to the test. Now factoring in those 6 hours a month for 2 months and my total earnings at $22.35, that's a whopping $1.86 per hour. So I'll save the best for last, and we will go on next to Jake.
Wow.
So Jake reported around 9 hours in total. Userlytics, a whopping $0. User Testing, though, he made $25, and TryMyUI, he made $16. So that's a grand total of $41 divided by 9 hours, and that's an hourly rate of $4.55. Also, you know, not something to write home about, but all said and done, that's $41 over the 2 month span, so which isn't, you know, terrible, but when looking at that hourly wage, that is pretty low. Certainly not good, considering what he's been averaging with affiliate marketing or any other, really, like literally anything else. So last but certainly not least is my wife. She stays at home, so she had a bit more time She spent a total of 18 hours spent on this. Now, I'm not sure what it is, but her demographic, she got approved for a ton of tests. So here it is. Userlytics was $38 with user testing $16 and then try my UI $12. Now, she's definitely made the most amount here. However, she made $66 in total, right, over 2 months. However, the fact that she spent 18 hours on this made it average out to around $3.66 per hour. Now, this hourly discrepancy, right, between what a lot of these people are claiming really is because it takes a while to go on these websites, apply for jobs, and often get denied, or, you know, just look around for different jobs. So you have to factor that into the time you spend on this, right? A test on its own is usually only an hour, maybe the most two. And if that's the case, you can easily average 15, maybe even 20, 25 bucks an hour. But when you're factoring in all the extra time that goes into it, which you should, that is not a very good return on your investment. So, would I do it again? Would they do it again? Now, obviously, you can hear my input here. No, I wouldn't do this again. Now, here is what Jake had to say when asked if he would be willing to do it again. As you can see, he is not really into it. And then my wife. So, like I said, you know, she put the most amount of time into this, so I wanted to see, you know, firsthand, like, is this something that's feasible? Is this something that somebody can do long term? And yeah, you can just check out her response. Let me know if she's gonna jump for joy the next time I ask her to do this. This stuff is just not really worth the time if you can get an hourly wage that is honestly $8 or more. If you can't, then yeah, sure, it's a good supplement. But yeah, I guess it's really up to you.